How is it going today, Loyalist Kingdom Minds? Dwayne.
Name's Jasmine.
We're Dwayne and Jasmine. We have Beerus versus Sailor
Galaxia.
Galaxia. Thank you, Jasmine. Dragon Ball versus Sailor Moon. Dev Battle. We haven't did Dev Battle in a while. There's some copyright issues going on.
But it's now all, I think they're gone.
It's good now. So. We should be okay. If you guys have any extra requests, please follow us on social medias and the link in the description. Don't forget to subscribe. Let's dive on in.
Alright, let's get back into it.
Yeah, it's been a long time.
Everything that lives must die. Everything that is created must be destroyed. Mm. So saith these vanguards of the apocalypse.
Badass. But when they gotta be a golden ballerina and a purple cat?
Lord Beerus,
yes.
The almighty god of destruction.
Love him.
And Empress Galaxia, the sailor scout of destruction from Sailor Moon.
Mm-hmm. I'm unfamiliar, but I'm gonna learn today.
And it's our job to analyze their weapons.
It's been a while since I saw Sailor Moon.
Find out who would win.
I need to be refreshed.
Battle.
Yes.
Son Goku. This Super Saiyan has seen his fair share of world. No. Universe and
right.
But oh, he hadn't seen anyone treat mass slaughter like a job until he met a god of destruction.
Mm. Yeah.
Because it
just
is
he wants to.
A god of destruction's role is to, well, destroy ancient planets and civilizations to make way for the new.
Sort of like taking out the trash, just with a billion times more murder.
Mm-hmm. And in the case of Universe Number 7, the title of Destroyer was granted to Lord Beerus.
Mm-hmm.
A cat.
Obviously,
I want to get a background movie on Beerus.
I mean,
we really don't know much about him.
Hell, God of Destruction is what my ex-wife named her.
Fun fact, while dogs have been bred as companions for thousands of years, the show only technically started for cats around 200 years
ago. In Egypt?
In comparison, they're still sort of wild animals, which makes them self-sufficient, but also standoffish.
And lazy.
Then Beerus may be the apotheosis of all cats. When he's not effortlessly annihilating solar systems, he's napping for decades.
Oh, but when he
inspired by Toriyama-san's own cat.
He's way stronger and faster than any mortal. Look at him go! That's his God of Destruction's wrath technique. He's got spears of destruction, beams of destruction,
things
of destruction, giant energy yarn balls of destruction, cataclysmic orbs.
Yeah. He can neutralize energy attacks from others, which is frankly just unfair. But his most awe-inspiring technique is Hakai.
Yep.
See, his enormous level of power stems from an unearthly source. To demonstrate, allow me to introduce our brand new disposable unit for meticulous matchup investigations, aka
what is that?
Domi.
Hello, Mr. Wizard. How may I be exploited today?
Exploited?
Now, generally speaking, there are three types of ki, which, to be blunt, is weaponizable life energy. First, there's normal ki. Most people in the Dragon Ball multiverse have this. Nothing too special. Gods have
it's
their
gonna
own
get worse
ki,
and worse.
Way more potent, but like all ki, they have a limited amount. But when you want the good stuff, you go for destruction energy.
So much for your new sidekick, Wiz.
Oh, no, there's plenty more.
Aww.
He channels this energy to obliterate something in an instant, erasing both body and soul from existence.
Wow.
He needed that confirmation. He was like, all right, cool. Destroy you.
Power.
And he didn't get so strong on his own. He's trained for millions of years under this guy, also named Wiz.
No, Wiz.
Yeah, that's what I said. He learned pressure point
coming
in the super secret Ultra Instinct.
More a state of mind than actual transformation. Autonomous Ultra Instinct describes the ability to instantly respond to attacks without conscious thought getting in the way.
Like he's on a catnip hunt.
With Ultra Instinct, he could even take on multiple other gods of destruction
when was
at
this?
The same time.
The only
this is a manga.
He got kind of bored. So he was hyped when he learned there was someone out there who might be a challenge for him.
Mm-hmm.
The Super Saiyan God. And in their fight over the fate of the Earth, they almost destroyed the whole universe.
Yes.
Our own observable universe is a respectable 93 billion light years across.
Sheesh.
However, the Dragon Ball universe is noticeably different, as depicted by this symbolic model. The observable universe as we know it fits within that bottom area.
Then there's hell in the middle, heaven up top, a bunch of dinosaurs sprinkled in there somewhere. It's kind of a mess.
A single clash between Beerus and Goku sent ripples of energy rocketing through this entire macroverse in just 7 seconds. With conservative calculations, these shockwaves must have been moving well over 240 quadrillion times the speed of
light. I gotta look at a good map of that.
Yeah.
I've never seen that before.
Yeah.
Minutes. so no surprise there. And when him and his fathead brother Champa got into a fight, they almost tore apart the whole universe themselves. Now talk about a cat fight.
But despite his incredible power, Beerus eventually did the one thing nobody ever expected. He showed mercy and spared Earth. Perhaps he saw a glimmer of greatness in Goku's potential, as so many have before him.
Nah, he's just a sucker for
the food. That food, right?
That human food, he's anything different.
Realizing the full terror of Beerus the Destroyer.
Just keep feeding him and he won't destroy you.
Yep. The galaxy, the solar system, the planet, the moon. Each is an essential piece in the ever-shifting whirlwind of the cosmos.
That's why they all have their own super protector, fighting evil by moonlight, winning love by daylight. They are the classic Magical Girls.
The Sailor Guardians are warriors entrusted with magnificent powers. Mm-hmm. It's the Sailor Guardians' job to protect the world from alien threats. Mm-hmm. You may know one of them, Sailor Moon. Mm-hmm. Real name, Usagi Tsukino. Or Serena, or
you know, let me pause real quick before we go. I know, I know. The crazy thing that me and Jasmine learned is that the Japanese schoolgirl outfit is actually based on sailors.
Sailors, yeah.
Right. Me and Jasmine was like, what?
Yeah. That's why they kind of look like Navy uniforms a little bit.
Right. And we was like, oh, that makes sense. And why would they choose sailor outfits of all outfits to make a school uniform?
I honestly would wear those uniforms than the ones I had to wear.
Yeah. They were ugly. Yeah, I had to tuck in a shirt, khakis. Yeah.
Yeah, like, ugh.
Yeah,
well, at least you had khakis. Lucky.
Yeah, what?
I didn't have that.
Y'all didn't have khakis?
No.
What y'all have?
Okay, I went from, it was blue, light blue shirts with the navy blue pants, mm-hmm. or white shirts with the navy blue pants, to white with the gray pants. That's it. And there's no style in that. So yeah. It's just all ugly. Mm-hmm. Everybody walking around just ugly.
Yeah. Feel bad.
Watch. So are they like space Popeyes who sell cookies?
What?
Sailor? Scouts! Go, Wiz!
They're not sailors, they're sailor guardians or sailor soldiers. Mm-hmm. The term sailor scout comes from the original English dub.
Oh, yeah! The dick dub! Look out!
Oh, kid. What?
There's a giant dick outside your window!
Oh!
Oh, wow!
Okay.
You know what you are.
Anyway, everything in the universe possesses a form of crystallized life force called a starseed. Each guardian is powered by a special starseed, which embodies their own planet, a sailor crystal.
Yes.
These give them superhuman powers. They can fly, do magic, shapeshift, heal fast, and are basically immortal. Some of them are even trained by the most dangerous creatures in the world. Cats.
After many adventures, Sailor Moon would eventually find herself face to face with her greatest foe, a cold-hearted empress of evil.
She was just a nameless lady stuck on some random trashy planet. It was so bad there, she basically gave up on life. Well, until she got her hands on the Sapphire Crystal.
The Sapphire Crystal is exponentially powerful, providing unlimited potential that matched her own newly unlimited ego.
Sheesh.
With all this power amongst the garbage around her, one purpose came to mind.
Destroy
everything.
So into the universe she went in search of a new home fit for a goddess, the Soldier of Destruction, Sailor Galaxia.
Be it the power or her own mind, Galaxia was cursed with unparalleled vanity, so cosmic in scale that she could not be satisfied until the whole universe bowed before her.
She likes sitting.
Just like my ex-wife. If she appeared on the horizon, you'd be totally screwed.
Oh my gosh.
Galaxia or your ex-wife?
Yes. Galaxia can make explosions big enough to blot out galaxies and even match the maxed out Eternal Sailor Moon in a fight. Who destroyed a whole mirror universe?
With a simple gesture, Galaxia can wipe anything out of existence. Planets, people, other guardians.
Just like Beerus could.
But she's got all sorts of other magic powers. Teleporting, summoning lightning, mind controlling people by taking their star seeds.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah, she can totally do that.
And like any good anime villain,
scary.
Her attacks have some absolutely ridiculous names. Like the Galactica Super String.
Which doesn't actually use any string.
Galactica Crunch.
I think I had a bowl of that this morning.
And Galactica Inflation.
Galactica what?
What the hell?
Well, how did that get there? It's not what you think. Research. You come across a lot of stuff in research.
What is that?
Exactly what kind of guy I'm working with.
So Galaxia carved through the universe.
Why did it have to be blown out?
Was that nasty?
Her own widespread empire.
She was so friggin' terrifying that some people would murder their own Sailor Scout as a sacrificial offering just to save themselves.
Wow.
Magical girls are metal as hell.
But Galaxia's destructive path wasn't as reckless as it may seem. Through her travels, she learned of a looming threat to the universe, a primordial entity and source of all evil. And so she vowed to destroy chaos.
Yeah, that happens if you watch too much Marie Kondo.
But to maintain balance, she also sought to destroy the opposite of chaos, the embodiment of love and goodness, which is apparently Sailor Moon.
This is where different stories get a bit wonky.
Right. In the anime, Galaxia was a heroic warrior who absorbed chaos to keep it under control.
Okay.
But chaos flipped the script and took her body instead.
Ooh.
However,
oh, wow.
This did not happen in the original manga.
Galaxia's war path led her to Earth, and she annihilated all the favorite Sailor Scouts. Every single one.
Jeez.
Except Sailor Moon.
Of
they
course.
Had to have their epic battle.
And Moon is a powerhouse. She once lit up the entire universe with a single attack. This light reached the edge of the universe in 4 seconds, putting it at 360 quadrillion times light speed.
Galaxia was tough enough to survive the grip of chaos itself. And with her crystal, she never has to worry about running out of energy in a fight. This chick's basically unkillable.
Well, the intense forces of chaos almost ended
her
life
80%
until she was saved by Sailor Moon.
And guess what? Apparently, this caused Galaxia to question her resolve and see Meatball Head here in a new light. Like, hey, maybe this lovey-dummy goodness stuff ain't so bad. And then, bam! Her crystal exploded from positivity overload, and she died.
What?
Neither Galaxia nor the Sapphire Crystal could ever know this feeling. Ironically, or perhaps befittingly, the weakness of destruction itself was love.
Okay. Whiz, she was literally killed by kindness. Who wrote this?
Nuance, Boomstick. Regardless, the power Galaxia wields is astonishing. Beneath the heel of her boot, any planet, galaxy, or universe is utterly doomed.
For this fight belongs to Sailor Galaxia.
Oh, that was a nice little transition right there.
You saw that? That's that 90s flex right there.
Like it. Look at me eating. Just chilling
just
until
chilling
somebody
to, yo,
disrupts
have to interrupt it. Ooh.
It's unwise to vaporize a god's dessert.
She messed with his food.
Witness my infinite power.
He's just poking me in the eye.
I've chosen death.
So we're just gonna do that over and over? I guess so. They ripped the universe.
Ridiculous. Perish!
Interesting.
Ooh.
Apparently, I found a worthy foe.
I love Bear's voice, boy.
I do too.
The hard way it is, then.
Oh, there goes the string. Remember having to fight against that in the game?
Yep, Kakarot?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Oh. Ooh.
Oh.
No.
No, there's no way he got hit by that.
Don't you dare.
Grabbing his tail. Sheesh.
Right. Woo! Did they just destroy the sun?
Yeah, they destroyed everything around them. They already destroyed the planet.
I mean, yeah.
Now look what you've done.
This is all about you stupid cat.
Goodness.
Hello there, stranger. Welcome.
That's another planet.
Oh, what a...
Wait.
Kneel for me.
You said Sims? Sims or Sims?
Sims. Welcome. He said forget this.
Right. Oh, aww. My goodness.
Are there other planets just getting destroyed? In the process. Is that a black hole now?
Did they just create a black hole, bro?
Oh, no.
die! No fair!
She threw him in a black hole.
So he's just gonna keep getting punted in there?
Nope.
There we go.
Ultra Instinct.
She didn't transform yet, though.
No.
Oh, my.
No.
Oh? All the seed.
Wait.
She's taking it.
Oh, take
it. That's impossible.
I'm not just gonna watch you take it. There you go. I think I'm not just gonna watch you transform.
Impossible.
Ooh.
That was for my ice cream.
I like it.
Holy crap, this fight was so intense. I'm gonna get a beer for us. Wait, beer us whiskey.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god, all the cats are named after booze. I like
are
it.
They?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Galaxia's power set was certainly enough to keep up with Beerus.
Especially since she has so many more versatile techniques than him.
Not to mention, her crystal provided unlimited energy, while Beerus had a vast but still finite pool of ki.
But that's about where it all starts tilting the other way. Based on how fast their galaxy-spanning attacks were,
Galaxia
did have a slight edge in attack speed.
Oh, she's faster.
Ultra Instinct made up for it. Plus, he had expert martial arts training. Galaxia had none of that. Speed alone wasn't winning this fight.
Also, Beerus's skill set countered many of her own attacks. His energy nullification, for example, let him blast through plenty of her offensive options.
But to really lock down Beerus's superiority in all things destruction, how about we compare their power output?
Both of them use attacks that span their whole universe in seconds. But remember, the Dragon Ball universe is much bigger than our own.
Right. Oh, wow. This universe is at least 9 times bigger than ours, and Beerus almost destroyed it all.
For the most part, the universe in Sailor Moon is very much based on our own. And the same should be said for Nehellenia's mirror universe Usagi destroyed.
So, pretty clear cut? That means Beerus is 9 times stronger than Galaxia?
Well, not exactly. They both are likely much stronger. Galaxia matched Endgame Eternal Sailor Moon in battle, who could destroy 8 of her Animamate minions at once.
Did you say Animorphs?
Long story short,
I remember that
single Animamate could match a Sailor Guardian equal in power to Sailor Moon when she destroyed that mirror universe. While this is admittedly a very highball estimate, defeating 8 Animamates at once could logically translate to possessing 8 times that power. Since Galaxia could match her in combat, this potentially puts Galaxia's output level much closer to Beerus and Goku's clash.
But the shockwave happened when Goku had only just gone Super Saiyan God for the first time. Beerus claimed he was going all out with 100% of his power.
But like
all cats, he was lying.
Telling Goku that you were using 100% of your power was a very clever tactic to draw out his full strength, even though it wasn't true.
Even after Goku later achieved Super Saiyan Blue with Kaioken, a form many, many times more powerful than his first go at being a redhead, Beerus was still considered his superior. Simply put, even if we highball Galaxia and lowball Beerus, the God of Destruction still possessed a greater amount of power, both in offense and defense, as they are identical when it comes to Dragon Ball.
As he should.
Yes.
Isn't that right, dummy?
Sailor Galaxia may have had a more versatile arsenal, but Lord Beerus had the strength, durability, and technique needed to overpower her. But you already said all that, so what's the point? Like my existence.
Aww.
You could say she got caught in a galaxy-sized catastrophe. Can I blow him up this time?
I look forward to it.
Is Lord Beerus.
Of course it is. Of course it better happen.
Our favorite cat. Okay, next time, what's happening? What is that?
Oh, Todoroki and Prince Zuko.
Oh! Be rooting for
It's gonna be fire and lightning versus fire and ice.
That's probably why you guys were saying that in my live stream yesterday, because I was like, what?
Just playing Fall Guys.
I didn't even know who would win, Todoroki versus Zuko, because Todoroki got both fire and ice, so he could like kind of nullify out the fire for Zuko,
but Zuko has that.
Zuko could control lightning.
We're going to see. That's going to be exciting. Yeah, that's going
to...
Send
it back to him, so I don't know how that's going to go.
That's going
to
be a fun fight.
Right.
It's going to be super fun. Anyway, I'm hyped for that.
Ooh.
Anyway, guys, comment below. Let us know what you think.
Don't forget to like,
subscribe,
and share.
Some more.